أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. In the name of Allah, the most compassionate, the most merciful, all praise belongs to Allah, the Rabb of the universe, who is the most compassionate, the most merciful, and the master of the day of recompense. You alone do we worship, and you alone we seek help. Guide us to the straight path, the path of those whom you have favored, and not the path of those with whom you are angry, nor the path of those who have gone astray. Respected listeners, Surah Al-Fatiha, the beginning of the Quran, it is the opening surah of the Quran. Al-Fatiha itself means the opening. So this is the opening to the Quran, also the opening, the starting of our Salah. When we start our Salah, we recite the Surah Fatiha, and also the opening of the Nuzul of Wahy. Because a lot of the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhu ajma'in have been quoted saying that the Wahy started with Surah Al-Fatiha. So the ulama, the muhaddiseen, they have interpreted this, that as a complete surah, Surah Al-Fatiha was the first surah to be revealed. Yes, the ayat of Surah Iqra and Surah Muzzammil Muddathir were revealed to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, certain various ayat. But as a complete surah, Surah Fatiha was the first one to be revealed as a whole to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And Surah Fatiha, it has many names, many different names. Some of the common names, which are Ummul Quran or Ummul Kitab, meaning the essence of the Quran, the essence of the book, because it has been given this name because it contains the essence of the detailed subject matter found in the other surahs. And this is the summary of the whole Quran. In this surah, the Aqaid, Iman, this is explained briefly. This is the summary of the whole Quran. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam himself has mentioned, the narration is mentioned in the Tirmidhi. Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu mentions that Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, Ummul Quran, wa Ummul Kitab, wa Sab'ul Mathani, wa Al-Quran Al-Azim. The Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, this surah, this is the Ummul Quran, this is also the Ummul Kitab, and wa Sab'ul Mathani, another name for Surah Fatiha, the seven repeated ayat, because there are seven ayat in the surah. Another name for Surah Al-Fatiha is Sab'ul Mathani, the seven repeated ayat, and Al-Quran Al-Azim. This is mentioned in the narration of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Another name for the Quran is Ash-Shifa, because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam himself mentions in the hadith that Fatihatul Kitab shifa'un min kulli saqm. It's a narration in Bayhaqi, fi shu'b al-rawahu al-Bayhaqi fi shu'b al-Iman. Abu Sa'id Khudri radiallahu ta'ala mentions this narration that the Fatihatul Kitab, the opening surah, this surah is shifa, is a cure from all illnesses. So this is a remedy, a cure from all illnesses, and also is known as rafiya, the remedy. And this we understand from the story of Abu Sa'id Khudri radiallahu ta'ala, which is mentioned in the Sahihain, in Bukhari and Muslim, in both these books of hadith. Then the narration is mentioned where some companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they came to a qawm, to a nation, and amongst them the tribal leader, the chief of the tribe, he was poisoned. The area that they went to, the chief was poisoned, and he asked the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhu ajma'in, that is there any rafi amongst you, meaning is there any person who can cure, who knows the remedy for such illnesses. So Abu Sayyid Khudri radiallahu ta'ala says that himself, he presented, he said, yes, I can cure. And he used this surah, Surah Al-Fatiha, to cure this person. He blew on this person and he was cured. He was stung by a snake. So this surah, Surah Al-Fatiha, was used by Abu Sayyid Khudri radiallahu ta'ala. And when the Sahaba, they came back to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they had to obviously ask Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam if this is correct, because in exchange for this remedy, they were given something to eat, or some meat or something. some goat meat. So the Sahaba radiallahu anhu, there was ikhtilaf in the Sahaba, that should we eat this or not? Is it permissible to eat this? And when they came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked him, how did he ask? He asked the Sahabi, he asked Abu Sa'id Khudri radiallahu anhu, how did you cure him? So Abu Sa'id Khudri radiallahu anhu said, that I used al-Fatiha, I used Surah Fatiha to cure him. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, on this he smiled, and he said to him, وَمَا يُدْرِيكَ أَنَّهَا رُقِيَةً. How do you know that this is a remedy, this is a cure? So from this hadith we understand that this Surah Al-Fatiha is a cure, is shifa. There's shifa in this. So if we have any illnesses, if we have a fever or flu or any kind of illness, this Sahabi, he used it to cure a person who was stung by a snake. He was poisoned. And that person was cured through Surah Al-Fatiha. So it's about the yaqeen that we need to build, the yaqeen that we need to have, that there's shifa in this Quran, there's shifa in this Surah Fatiha. So every time we have any illness, yes, we take the medication as well, but before that, we turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to cure us, and we use the Quran to cure ourselves. Use the Quran, recite Surah Al-Fatiha three times, seven times, blow on ourselves, blow on the water and drink it. Inshallah, if we have the firm faith, we will get shifa and we will be cured. And this is the reality. Because the cure is in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We all understand that a person, two people with the same illness, if they go to the doctor, and the doctor would prescribe them the same medication. Now, they've got the same illness, they've been prescribed the same medication. But yet we see one person gets cured, the other person doesn't get cured. What do we understand from this is that the cure is not in the medication, the cure is in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The medication is just a means. So this is why we need to make an effort on our iman. And then with this iman and this belief, when we recite Surah Al-Fatiha, inshallah, we'll be cured. So every time we have an illness or any problem, we should turn to the Quran, recite the Quran, and use this for shifa. This is the most virtuous surah in the Quran, as the riwayah of Tirmidhi. It's mentioned an Abi Hurairah radiyallahu anhu an Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qala li Ubay bin Ka'b. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam radiyallahu anhu mentions that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said to Ubay bin Ka'b radiyallahu ta'ala an, atuhibbu an u'allimaka suratan lam yanzil fi at-tawrat wala fi al-injil wala fi az-zabur وَلَا فِي الْفُرْقَانِ مِثْلُهَا. Would you like that I teach you a surah which has not been revealed in the Tawrat or the Injil or the Zabur or even in the Quran itself, the like of this surah? So Ubay bin Ka'b radiallahu ta'ala, he said, نعم, Ya Rasulullah, yes, I would like you to teach me such a surah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, قال Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, كَيْفَ تَقْرَعُ فِي الصَّلَاةِ قال فَقَرَعَ أُمُّ الْقُرْآنِ. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught him the surah which is recited in the Salah, which was the Suratul Fatiha, and then he recited the Suratul Fatiha itself. فَقَالَ رَسُولَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. At the end, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم again repeated that وَالَّذِي نَفْسِي بِيَدِهِ مَا أُنزِلَتْ فِي التَّوْرَاتِ وَلَا فِي الْإِنْجِيلِ وَلَا فِي الزَّبُورِ وَلَا فِي الْفُرْقَانِ مِثْلُهَا. He took oath, he swore by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by the being in whose life the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم's life is. He took an oath and he said that مَا أُنزِلَتْ فِي التَّوْرَاتِ, such a surah has not been revealed in the Tawrat, in the Injil, in the Zubur, and not even in the Quran. So this such a surah has not been revealed in the books which were given to the Anbiya before Rasulullah ﷺ, neither is there a like of the surah in the Quran itself. This is how special the surah is. This is the most virtuous surah of the Quran. Also, another name of the surah is As-Salah. Why? Because in Sahih Muslim, the hadith of Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala an, in which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, قال الله عز وجل, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself says, قسمت الصلاة بيني وبين عبد نصفين. That I have distributed the salah. Over here, the salah is referred to as Suratul Fatiha. I have distributed Suratul Fatiha, and the word used is Salah. So another name for Surah Al-Fatiha is Salah. Between myself and my Abd, my servant, in two halves. I'll mention the whole narration, inshallah, because it's very beneficial. But the point I want to mention is this is another name for Surah Al-Fatiha, As-Salah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this Hadith Al-Qudsi, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that I have distributed Surah Al-Fatiha in two portions. وَلِعَبْدِ مَا سَأَلْ And for my person, for my servant, is what he asked for. فَإِذَا قَالَ الْعَبْدِ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ When the person recites الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ All praise is for the Lord of the worlds. قَالَ اللَّهُ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala replies to this, حَمِدَنِي عَبْدِي That my servant has praised me. And then when the person, فَإِذَا قَالَ الرَّحْمَنُ الرَّحِيمُ And when the person says الرَّحْمَنُ الرَّحِيمُ The most merciful, most compassionate, the most merciful, قَالَ اللَّهُ أَثْنَى عَلَيَّ عَبْدِي Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala replies to this, that my servant has extolled me, my servant has praised me. فَإِذَا قَالَ مَالِكِ يَوْمِ الدِّينِ When the person recites مَالِكِ يَوْمِ الدِّينِ The Lord of the Day of Recompense, the Lord of the Day of Judgment, قَالَ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says مَجَّدَنِي عَبْدِي My servant, my slave has glorified me. وَقَالَ مَرَّةً فَوَّضَ عِلَيَّ عَبْدِي And on one occasion the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala replies to Maliki yawm al-Din with فَوَّضَ عِلَيَّ عَبْدِي meaning my slave has submitted to my power. Then when the person recites إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ قَالَ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says هَذَا بَيْنِي وَبَيْنَ عَبْدِي This is between me and my servant. وَلِعَبْدِي مَا سَأَلْ And for my servant is what he has asked for. So إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينُ When we recite that you alone do worship and you alone do we seek help, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to this, He replies that this is between me and my slave and for my slave is what he has asked for. فَإِذَا قَالَ اِهْدَى الصِّرَاطُ الْمُسْتَقِيمُ صِرَاطُ الَّذِينَ أَنَمْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ غَيْرُ الْمَغْضُوبِ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا الضَّالِّينَ آمين Till the end, when the person recites this, that guide us to the straight path, the path of those whom you have favored, and know the path of those who have earned your anger, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala replies to this, هَذَا لِعَبْدِي وَلِعَبْدِي مَا سَأَلْ This is for my servant, and for my servant is what he has asked for. This is, when we recite Surah Al-Fatiha, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is replying. That's why Umar radiallahu ta'ala mentions, I think it was Umar radiallahu ta'ala, that when I want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to talk to me, I recite the Qur'an. Because this is the kalam of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when I want Allah to talk to me, I recite the Quran. And when I want to talk to Allah, I stand in salah. So when we stand in salah, when we are reciting, this is the reply that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives to all the verses of the Surah Al-Fatiha. This is why we should understand, you know, the meaning, whatever we are reciting, at least with whatever we are reciting in our salah. You know, read the meaning, learn the meaning. This will help us concentrate in our salah. We will know what we are reciting. Not just memorizing the sabak of the salah and reading it. We need to understand what we are reciting. This will make our ibadah fruitful. We will taste the sweetness of our ibadah, inshallah. This is why it's very important that we understand the meaning of the Quran as well, and also at least minimum learn the meaning of the Surah Al-Fatiha and the surahs that we recite in the Quran, and whatever the dua that we recite in our salah, so that in our salah we know what we are conversating with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we know what we are reciting. And this will help us concentrate in our salah. So inshallah we'll carry on from here next week. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us all the understanding of the Quran and Hadith. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the ability to act upon the teachings of the Quran and Hadith, and also give us the ability to propagate this tradition. Ameen wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillah.